You can see it when you look out your window or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work, when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
In my previous video, titled Halloween Mischief, The Unclean Spirit, I made it a point to mention Revelation 16:14 in reference to evil spirits, spirits in general, and what they are, and what it means for the dead to be truly dead. And as you can see, it clearly says that these are the spirits of devils working miracles. And I also went to 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 14 and 15. For Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. And in that video, I said, oh, well, doesn't that sound familiar? And I put some aliens on the screen. And it made me think, it's like, well, you need to make a video about this because we have to discuss the transformation. Now, let's look at transform for a minute. To make a thorough or dramatic change in form, appearance, or character of. A product of transformation. Let's look at transformation real quick. A thorough or dramatic change in form or appearance. So these evil spirits, Satan, the fallen angels, are able to transform into pretty much anything they want to transform into, right? So the mentioning of aliens brings us to things like shapeshifters, and the list of alien species, if you will, is rather vast, and I'm only going to mention a few. The information is out there if you want a more thorough list. There are the alien greys, right? We have Nordics, tall whites, the reptilians. The reptilians are quite a thing, right? The reptilian shapeshifters. The Anunnaki. And then you have something called the insectoids, giant bugs, right? From outer space. So ask yourself, do you believe in this tiny alien list? I mean, people claim that you can see alien shapeshifting before your eyes in certain videos and certain pictures. The eyes are a big deal. You know, everybody in Hollywood is an alien shapeshifter. Now, it's not just aliens. Consider Hollywood in general, right? I mean, Hollywood loves to promote the demon. And that's why alien movies are so popular. People just love the alien. The thing with me with aliens, though, you look at all of the photographs, the supposed photographs of UFOs. A lot of them are just grainy blobs that don't really look like much of anything. I think a lot of it has to do with a time period. I mean, you look at the late 40s into the 50s and the 60s and you get UFOs that look like they are from that time period. You jump forward to now, and, you know, castles float in the sky. I mean, for instance, do you think that this particular photograph was actually an alien spacecraft? Again, a time period, a timepiece. I think it's at that point in time, the elitists' way of still trying to hoodwink, you know, the American public, the world in general. And now it's to the point where people believe that aliens are actually running the world. Now, for one moment, take a step back and think, yes, these things do transform. Yes, you're seeing it. Right? Maybe these eyes are actually demon eyes. Would it be possible to think that way for a moment and not have it be like this reptilian being from another planet? Why couldn't it just be the fallen angels still playing games? meant to deceive the public? Why does it have to be something from another planet? And then you have to think about, well, I mean, if they can travel all that distance and they are so far superior to us and so much more technically advanced, why would they bother to come here? And why do all of the movies constantly say they're just going to destroy the Earth? What purpose would that serve? Think of the light years, okay, the supposed light years. And I say supposed on this end, that's another topic for another time. But let's just consider space for a moment, and can you travel in it? Now, I've already stated that I believe aliens to be fallen angels, interdimensional beings. There's a difference between traveling a light year or 15 light years or however many light years as opposed to, I don't know, let's call it veil jumping, you know, tearing a hole in the veil. I mean, don't think for a minute that the good people of CERN aren't trying to figure out how to tear that veil. It's much more than just wanting to recreate life. We can already do that. It's called birth. And I absolutely believe that when it comes to things like CERN and all of this technology, they definitely want to figure out how to get to heaven. That's the point. Satan can no longer go back to heaven. The fallen angels can no longer go back to heaven. That's the game being played. Satan can't go back. He doesn't want you to go there either. The manipulation is to figure out how to get man to tear the veil so we can go to heaven without God being a factor. That's the point. That's the point to all of these aliens. And it's not just aliens. When I talk about Hollywood, look at the vampire. The vampire is a shapeshifter. It's another way for Hollywood to glorify fallen angels, to glorify demons, right? The werewolf, right? Another shapeshifter, transformation, just like the Bible says. These are evil spirits that can transform into anything they want, and Hollywood throws it in your face with aliens, with vampires. I mean, take Bigfoot, take Nessie, right? The Mothman, right? People say they have seen fairies, goblins, the shadow people, right? And whatever else might be out there. Take any god with a lowercase g. Throughout our recorded history from any mythology book, it doesn't matter which god you choose, they were all fallen angels meant to deceive the entire time. This is all a form of demonic activity. Don't think for a second that these things aren't trying to deceive you, to manipulate you. And all of this technology that has been given to us, I'm absolutely convinced that man is going to figure out how to do it, because the fallen angels already know. They've already been kicked out. And I just think it's a sad state of affairs that people can be manipulated to that point of actually helping Satan and the fallen angels do their dirty work. And I wanted to make it very clear that this transformation, right, the spirits of devils working miracles, it's not just about Halloween, it's every single day. I've said it before and I'll keep saying it, you get two choices. You have God through Jesus Christ, you have Satan through man. And Satan has a whole bunch of minions called the fallen angels whispering in everybody's ear. And that's called deception. And you can get down to the bloodlines that run this world. It goes back that far because those people know for a fact that everything mentioned in the Bible is absolutely 100% positively true. And those people are the ones being mentioned with this verse, whose end shall be according to their works, wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. The children of disobedience are the fallen angels, and anybody who chooses to follow them. Satan, who is the god of this world, has blinded the minds of those who don't believe. They are unable to see the glorious light of the good news. They don't understand this message about the glory of Christ, who is the exact likeness of God. For we are not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world, and against evil spirits in heavenly places. Again, you have two choices. You have God through Jesus Christ, and you have Satan through man. I do pray that you make the right choice, and may God bless you all.